just got to Disneyland. These are the temperature screening tents. Okay, so we just had to do a little health check on our phone, where we had to fill out some information and leave our phone number and passport number, but we're in, we're good. Finally got in. It was a long, sweaty wait, but we're in. Yay! I took a little screen recording of my phone on the Disney app for the park so you could take a look at some of the times, the wait times. This is at the very beginning of the day, so wait times weren't that long yet. You can also see that the map wasn't working really well. I think we just had too many people at the park all trying to access the app at the same time, maybe.
Treasure.
You got him. Good job, Lizzy. So we just got Barbosa's barbecue ribs, and also some Barbosa
bingsu.
Yeah, bingsu. Barbosa bingsu. That's what it said.
It's really good.
And we're actually inside the Pirates ride, and you can see it's really cool in here. And there's Lizzy eating ribs. And there's all kinds of pirate themes. Stuff. It's very cool. And this is actually the ride right here. So people are coming out of there. Yeah, very cool.
Alright, it's a little rainy. We're in line for
Seven Dwarves Mine Ride.
Mm-hmm. We have about an hour wait, 100 minute wait actually. So we'll be here for a while. Okay, we just rode Seven Dwarfs Mine Train.
Yeah, that was a really good one. It's very fun. It, like, really smooth little roller coaster.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was great. I like that one.
It was a good level of thrill. Like, you get the butterflies a little bit, but it's not painful. It's good.
Very smooth.
Voyage to the Crystal Grotto.
Yeah.
psyched up to go on Tron.
Yeah, it looks scary.
Don't look that bad. Okay.
Hello.
We just got off of Tron.
Yeah, Tron was incredible.
It was really good.
If you want to see how much we liked it, take a look at it. Yeah, we were pretty into it. Oh, there we go. It was a really good roller coaster. It was very fast. Well, I don't want to spoil it, but it starts off very, very fast. And you're on a light cycle. Here we go.
Whoa!
And it goes about 100 kilometers an hour. And you are on the blue team. You're trying to battle against the red team. Really, really smooth coaster. There's a dark part that's really fun.
Is this like the craziest one that you've been on of a Disney ride?
Yeah, I think this is the most intense Disney coaster for sure. I guess the second one would be California Screamin' at California Adventures, but for like a Disney ride, this was really intense. But honestly, it was a perfect roller coaster. Very, very smooth and like just really enjoyable. Lots of little drops and turns, and everything was really, really well done. People are screaming, they love it. And we loved it, it was awesome. I would give Tron 10 light cycles out of 10.
Check out Disney Town. There's a bunch of restaurants.
It's Disney Town.
Alright, we're gonna eat some lunch at Cheesecake Factory. It looks really good.
So, Lizzie, what did you order?
I ordered the pork tenderloin.
Okay. And I got the bacon cheeseburger. It comes with fries. And we also had some mozzarella sticks, but we already ate those.
And we might get some cheesecake there.
Yes. So we are in the very back. We're the last people in line for Soaring Over the Horizon, which currently has a 2-hour and 45-minute wait time. So we're gonna see what it's like to wait with us for 2 hours and 45 minutes. Oh, also, it's currently 5:45, so we'll see how long it takes. Pretty much the worst time because everyone keeps cutting and there's no workers at all in this line for some reason. This is the worst line, except for the line to get in the park. That was actually the worst line. So 1 hour into the line, still in line.
Okay. Soaring Over the Horizon is really good.
Yeah, that one was awesome. Lizzie was just saying how she's surprised it's not higher on the list of like must-do rides because, yeah, why'd you like it so much?
I think it was just really cool how they incorporated all the senses.
Yes.
Like they had smells coming out from different locations, like coming from above.
Yeah, like while you're flying over India, it smells like roses, and while you're flying over like African grasslands, it smells like grass. It was so cool.
Yeah.
We also waited in line for like 2 hours for this one, over 2 hours, but it was really great. I think it was worth it. This one was our last ride of the day, and it was really good. I like this one a lot. Yeah.
Well, I hope you enjoy coming along with us to Disneyland.
Yeah.
Shanghai.
Yeah.
Like and subscribe.
And don't forget to smash that like button. Overall, Disney Shanghai, I'll talk about it in another video. Bye.
Okay, we're going to interview our friends who came with us to Disneyland.
Yeah.
Okay, what was your favorite ride?
My favorite ride... Yeah, it was Tron.
Tron?
My favorite is Tron.
Tron? Nice.
Was it scary?
No, for me it's not scary.
Not scary?
No.
Okay, what was your second favorite ride?
The carousel.
Oh, that was cute.
Yeah, that's cute.
How about Winnie the Pooh? Did you ride that one?
Yeah.
Okay, what did you think about that one?
I thought that was really cute.
Yeah.
Was it?
Yeah.
Nice.
That's good. Was that one scary too?
It was the scariest. Yeah.
I think it's enough scary.
And you guys also did the rope course.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you also ate some pork fat, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The rope course was it was good because you got to like pick your own path. Every time that you went to like a challenge, there are three paths.
Yes.
And on one of them, you could just walk straight and there's just like a road.
Oh.
And on the other one is like, there were varying difficulties. So
it's not too hard.
Yeah, I like that.
Nice.
Cool.
Okay. Do you have any comparisons of this Disneyland to other Disneylands you've been to?
It feels a lot smaller.
Okay.
And there's like no carnival stuff. And that's one of my favorite things. I love carnivals.
I want to say is that the most interesting thing is the Frozen, the show.
Yeah, you can talk about it.
All of them is Chinese. And then including the song, the Let It Go, Let It Go. This is like the Shitapa, Shitapa.
And that's like very awkward.
Oh, really?
Like very awkward.
Yeah.
That's funny.
We wait online, and it takes us 1 hour. And then
Frozen.
Yeah, and then we watched the Chinese show.
Cool. That's very good.
Yeah,
that's
all the rides had Chinese. Like the Pirates one was all like Captain Jack Sparrow, and it was like very Chinese. The only English I could understand was Jack Sparrow.
Barbosa.
Barbosa. Cool. All right.
Awesome.
Hey. Okay, bye bye.
All right. Quick recap on Disney Shanghai. It's a lot of fun, but there was a lot of people here today. We had to wait in a lot of lines. We didn't get to do all the rides that we wanted to. Fast Pass didn't really work.
It worked once.
And then it was mayo.
Yeah, everything was mayo.
And the fireworks aren't happening. Those are mayo.
That's the saddest part because fireworks are like at Disneyland, like every night. That's like a big traditional Disney thing.
Yeah.
And today it is on the entertainment schedule, but basically it's mayo, so there's no fireworks today.
Yeah. The rides are really good. I would say the rides are fantastic.
Yeah,
that we
rides
went on.
Are great.
What was your favorite ride?
Put me on the spot. I would say Tron probably. Was really good. It was a really good roller coaster. I also really liked the Seven Dwarfs Mine Ride. That one turned out to be really fun.
Yeah.
That one was a little bit surprising because we never heard of it before, but it was a good little roller coaster. It was actually pretty quick and it was fun. It's very smooth. Also, Pirates was great. It was kind of like the Pirates in Disneyland in California, but almost like an upgraded version. I really liked that one. Also, it was really cool hearing all the animatronics in Chinese. Mm-hmm. It's different, and we don't speak really well Chinese. It was an interesting experience. So, also, what was really great, Soaring was really good. Yeah, Soaring over the horizon was fantastic.
The food was good.
Food is really good. The workers were all really helpful and friendly. All the workers say hi to you, and a lot of them spoke English, which was really great.
Getting into the park was a little difficult, but I think that's just because of COVID-related things. We're really grateful we could actually come. When you're outside, you don't have to wear your mask, but when you're in line, you have to have your mask on or on the rides.
It's pretty weird because a lot of people like just don't have their masks on, and then when someone comes by, everyone puts their mask on.
Yeah.
So that's kind of how it is.
It was an interesting experience.
And overall, I would say some of the biggest differences between Disney Shanghai and the other Disneys was like the line management because of all the pushing and cutting. There weren't really enough workers like stopping people from doing that. And some of the lines were very strange, like they would open up a rope and just let a lot of people rush through and like run to the next area
and then under the ropes.
And then put the rope back and then stop them and then they would wait and then they would let the next group like rush through. It
so
wasn't
was
very
strange.
Organized.
And if the ride waits were like 25 minutes, who cares, you know? But the ride waits were super long because they aren't using full capacity on the rides. They're using about 50% of the seats every time. So the waits were very long. Maybe we just came on a day where there's a lot of people and there's still stuff that they can't do because of COVID. But so maybe today was a little bit rough, but we still had a lot of fun. Yeah.
And we did try to come at one of the non-peak days. It's a Monday.
It's a Monday.
And according to the Disney Shanghai website, this was supposed to be not as busy of a day.
Right.
And even with them operating at not full capacity, it still felt like full capacity. Most of the rides, especially any of the roller coaster type rides, were at about a 75 to 90 minute wait minimum for the entire day from the time the park opened.
Our longest one?
Soaring.
Yeah.
Soaring was the longest. It was over 2 hours to get on Soaring.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, overall, Shanghai Disney is really great. I would say it could be better. There could be more rides. There could be more like kind of thrill rides and stuff like that. The line management could be better. But overall, it's still definitely Disney, and it still has that Disney feel. Everything's super clean. They keep the park really, really clean and nice, and the aesthetic is awesome. Like, it's a really great touch of Disney.
Well, thanks for watching.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.